Hey guys, Eternally Optimistic here with another vlog series-ish. I don't think this is going to be a weekly thing like How I Met Your Mother, because I've got other stuff that I need to be working on, but at the same time, I did want to share my thoughts about this series because it is discussion-worthy. And I just like to start out by saying that, for me, I don't really watch a lot of TV, at least not weekly. I don't really follow a lot of shows. If the things that I love the most, I often have discovered, years after they've been over. And to me, it's almost a more enjoyable way of consuming media because the show's already written in its entirety and there's, you don't follow it for seasons only to be, like, if the show goes in a different direction, if there are rewrites or, dropped storylines, there's less of an opportunity for there to be disappointment because you haven't been following it for years. That's what happened with How I Met Your Mother, and I came into that show halfway through season 7, and, it hit me really hard, so I have no idea what it was like for, people who've been following it since the beginning. My favorite show in the world, MASH, was over, years before I was born. Mystery Science Theater, another one of my favorite things. I didn't even know that existed until years after it was over. The big exception for me was The Last Airbender, because I got into that one right away. Like, the promos just hooked me and I knew I had to watch the show. And that show became better and better as, the series went on, culminating in that finale, which was amazing and better than, I ever could have imagined. So that, that was great to be part of and watch it, follow it from the beginning all the way through. But with Once Upon a Time, this is actually one show that I have been watching from the beginning, because I saw the promos and just, I was hooked on this concept. I love fantasy, and I really liked the idea of all these, fairy tale characters interacting and, watching their lives intertwine in new ways. That said, it's very much fan fiction. It's like the fairy tale soap opera fan fiction. And right away, that's, I know that's like a huge drawback for, a lot of people. The good thing is it is very much aware that it is fan fiction. Like, it's not even trying to hide that fact. So that makes it a little, easier to handle, and it seems to want to have fun with it. Like, it's not taking itself too seriously. So that, that makes it a little more enjoyable. In the beginning, it was just, we're just going to have fun with it, and we're just going to tell these stories with these fairy tale characters in new ways. And I was loving it. I was really enjoying seeing how the characters connected and seeing it like a fresh take on all these new stories. And I loved, one of my favorite things was finding out, because, in case you don't know, the premise of the story is that there's an alternate dimension where all of the fairy tale characters in these beloved stories are all real and they have, their own lives, but the evil queen from the Snow White story has put a curse on them all and brought them to our dimension. So now they live in a little town in Maine and they've been cursed, like frozen in time for years, and their daughter, the daughter of Snow White and Prince Charming is the one who's said to break the curse, and that's, she's the main character around which everyone else revolves. it got kind of complicated, but, so this little town in Maine called Storybrooke, this is the kind of show that it is. I thought that was pretty cute. If that turns you off, I won't hold that against you, I can see why. So all these fairy tale characters were transported to this town, and I loved seeing who they became in the town, because they all had something to do with their characters, like the evil queen became the mayor. Probably my favorite one was Jiminy Cricket became a therapist. Like, I loved that, and Archie's character was great, Dr. Hopper. And they all have, like, clever names like that in the real world, like Rumpelstiltskin is Mr. Gold, and he has a pawn shop. The huntsman from the Snow White story is the sheriff. Snow White is a teacher. It's just fun stuff like that. And the first season was pretty much just vignettes, in the fairy tale world and the real world happening simultaneously. It's not a linear story, you know, you're getting flashbacks at the same time that you're getting the forward momentum, which again is pretty confusing. If you don't like stories that aren't told, you know, in a linear fashion, don't even try, because this one gets pretty convoluted. It's a show that you almost have to watch from the beginning. You cannot come in midway through this thing. But the fantasy was enough, that was engaging enough, that I kept coming back throughout the first season. I guess my concern was the entirety of the whole appeal was based around seeing these characters in the real world under this curse. And I was concerned what was going to happen when the curse was broken, because it didn't seem like a story that was ripe for conflict otherwise, and the curse was broken at the end of the first season, which really surprised me. But they had built up the characters enough and introduced enough backstory and motivations that there was enough story to keep going, just not right away, because season two was awful. Just awful. The whole thing was just a pain to watch. I was watching out of obligation more than anything else. It wasn't entertaining, it wasn't enjoyable. Every episode was, I think the problem was I wanted the story to be moving forward, and I wanted to know what happened to the characters in the real world now that the curse was broken, and what do they try to get back to the fairy tale world, or, you know, what do they do in the real world now, and, we just weren't getting that. It was more backstory going way, way back, and I just didn't care, and it was so convoluted, and I think the problem was it got really predictable. There was so much melodrama and, flipping back and forth, like who's good and who's evil, and not, I'll get to, it didn't feel, it felt like, oh, shock drama, we're gonna, you know, a wham line every single episode to twist expectations, and it just made my head hurt after a while. It wasn't fun. Every episode had a major twist, and they got major twist, and it got to be the point where I could, you know, predict exactly when the twists were going to happen and what they were going to be. And, you know, I'm usually really bad at predicting big twists and plot developments, so that turned me off completely. In fact, I can remember exactly the episode that stopped me from watching anymore, and it was Pinocchio's backstory, when they go and they talk about what August was doing in the real world in China, and it just, oh, it was horrible to watch. And another thing, like I hate to say this, but he kind of deserved exactly what he got at the end of this episode, because the characters in this story are stupid. Like, they are so stupid, and it makes me sad, because there is some character development. Like, these are distinct personalities. They're fun. They're enjoyable to watch. They might even be people that you would like to know in real life, which is exactly what you want from characters, but even the smart ones make these stupidest mistakes when the plot requires that they make them. And that's what bothers me most about the show. It is so contrived in places. And that's exactly what this Pinocchio, it was really, really contrived. And it ended with the worst twist you could possibly imagine. So I just turned it off. I was like, nope, that's it. Finally, I have no feeling of obligation, like I need to be watching anymore. Almost like a curse had been lifted, you might say. I started seeing the previews for season 3 and for the Little Mermaid episode especially. And I remember, like, when this show first started out, the Little Mermaid was the one that everyone was talking about. Like, that was the story that they really wanted to see Once Upon a Time do. I don't know why, but, you know, I was no exception. That was the one I was really looking forward to as well. Something about how iconic that movie is. People really wanted to see it, and I started to see the promos, and I was like, oh, I gotta see at least what they did with this story.